To me, NAIDOC Week is a week where we can come together as one whole community to celebrate Aboriginal culture, our history, our achievements, and how diverse we are throughout Australia. My name is Ebony Frankel. I am a Karay Wurrung Gundijamaira woman. My family comes from Warrnambool in Victoria, from the Framlingham Mission. I grew up myself in the Riverland in Berry with my family there.
NAIDOC Week means a lot. I think any awareness or recognition of Indigenous people or any culture in that fact should be known, should be accepted. And with this education and awareness, I hope that all communities can be respected and behave towards each other in a civil and well-respected manner. My name is Chad Barmby, PSO First Class here at Government House. Australian born, I have an Indigenous background on my father's side. So my role in SAPOL is a protective security officer. I joined SAPOL to help the community, to protect and serve all in it.
This year we're celebrating Always Was, Always Will Be. Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people were first Australians. I think Aboriginal Torres Strait Islander people have such a spiritual connection to the land, and we look after the land, and that was always our responsibility, and still is. My name is Alison Norris. I'm a Nawaji woman, and I come from the Murang clan in Arnhem Land. My role in SAPOL is the business coordinator for Eastern District. I joined SAPOL because I wanted to make a difference in our communities. Unfortunately, I can't be a police officer, but what I can do is support behind the scenes the men and women that go out onto our streets every day and every night.
I joined the South Australia Police as a community constable because I liked the idea of policing and working with the Aboriginal community. From the moment that I got accepted into the police academy, I told myself that this was my opportunity to create some change and inspire young Aboriginal people and make my elders proud. I see NAIDOC Week as an opportunity for everyone to learn and move forward. It's an opportunity for conversation and to listen to stories and really understand our First Nations people.